Hello, everyone, and welcome to our school choice information session presented by Gaston County Schools. I am Todd Hagans, and it is a pleasure to have all of you with us today. This program is the first of four school choice information sessions that are designed to give parents and the community an opportunity to learn about the 21 dynamic school choice and magnet school programs that are available to students for the upcoming 2021-2022 academic year. During this session, we are highlighting five of our school choice programs: the Career Academy at Southwest Middle School, and representing Southwest is Principal Cindy Hester; the Career Academy at York Chester Middle School, and representing York Chester is the principal, Dr. Amy Holbrook; the Career Academy at Hunter Huss High School, and representing Hunter Huss is the principal, Dr. Brian Denton; the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy at Bessemer City Middle School, and representing Bessemer City Middle is the principal, Dr. Jessica Mellon; and the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy at Bessemer City High School, and representing Bessemer City High School is the principal, Dr. Sheila Wyant. And joining us also are Denise McLean, our Executive Director for Student Support Services, and Terry Serbeck, our Director of Student Assignment. As you all know, it is school choice time in Gaston County Schools, and we are currently accepting applications for all 21 of our choice programs. Parents may submit an application online by going to the Gaston County Schools website and clicking the School Choice Magnet Schools icon. You can also access the information through the Gaston County Schools mobile app. We want to let everyone know that the deadline to submit an application is Sunday, February 28th. Our school choice programs are open to students who are enrolled in Gaston County Schools, as well as students who are currently enrolled in a private school, charter school, virtual school, or homeschool program. Here is how today's webinar will work. We will give each school representative an opportunity to share information about the school program, the choice program at his or her school. Once we have shared about the five schools being featured during this session, we will give our webinar participants an opportunity to ask questions using the Q&A feature. First, we are going to focus on our Career Academy school choice programs at Southwest, York Chester, and Hunter Huss. We know that it is never too early for students to begin thinking about the future. At the middle school level, the Career Academy makes it possible for students to explore a variety of career fields so they can get an idea of job opportunities that await them in the future. At the high school level, the Career Academy provides coursework and hands-on training to prepare students for jobs in business, trade and industry, food service, public safety, health science, technology, and other areas. Students in the Career Academy at Hunter Huss have an advantage over their peers as they gain academic credit, career credentials, hands-on learning, and much more. Perhaps most of all, when students who have gone through the Career Academy graduate from high school, they are ready and prepared to go on to college or join the local workforce. Now it is time for our school presentations featuring our Career Academy, and we begin with the Career Academy at Southwest Middle School, and again with us is the principal, Cindy Hester. Ms. Hester, in 100 words or less, how would you describe your Choice Magnet program?
Thank you, Todd, for an opportunity to share about the Southwest Career Academy. At Southwest, our academy provides all students the opportunity to explore career pathways that directly impact their choices in high school and beyond. So each grade level academy has a theme that aligns with the course offerings at Hunter Huss and other high schools. The sixth grade academy focuses on health and public service. The seventh graders concentrate on business and information technologies. Our eighth grade academy does a deep dive into the family and human services pathway.
What are some of the classes or the courses or the pathways that are available to students in the Career Academy?
So in addition to our interdisciplinary coursework, where students learn about their grade level career pathway, Southwest does offer them and prepare them for the Honors Foods program offered by Hunter Huss, as well as Family and Consumer Sciences courses. Students have opportunities to take culinary classes, and we also offer a year-long art and coding classes, which prepare students for advanced honors courses at the high school level.
And Ms. Hester, what would you say is one thing that really makes your program stand out?
Well, Todd, one of the things that we are really proud of at Southwest is we are the only middle school that has grade level academies with an assistant principal, guidance counselor, and literacy content coach that loops with the students each year. This has provided us much needed support and consistency in the building and really helps us build those strong relationships with our students and families.
Okay, if you had to use only three words to describe your program, what are the three words?
Well, Todd, I think the three words that capture our program at Southwest would be career, pathway, exploration. These three words capture what we want all of our students to take away from their middle school experience at Southwest. We want them to see the relevance of what they learn about career pathways in the middle school as they make informed choices about potential career pathways and certifications and credentials they can earn while in high school. Some of these credentials include some amazing things students can do, such as becoming a CNA, an EMT. They can get ServSafe certification, Microsoft certification, WorkKey career readiness, just to name a few. We are super excited about those opportunities for our students.
And if you had to share or identify the most important thing that you want students and parents and the community to know about the Career Academy at Southwest, what should they know?
Well, Todd, our choice program is designed really to be that bridge between the middle school experience and what students can expect in high school. We want our school community to know that the Southwest Career Academy is a good choice for all students, regardless of their plans for high school and beyond. The credentials and certifications they can earn are what businesses are seeking in their employees and earn them higher wages if they are going directly into the workforce. Some students, however, will choose to earn college credits towards a two-year degree. And if that is their choice, they can also go on to a four-year college if they choose, and they have an advantage when applying with those additional credentials.
And Ms. Hester, thank you for that great overview of Southwest. And as we move to talk about the other Career Academy programs, you're probably going to hear some of the same information, because the two middle school programs are linked directly to the Career Academy at Hunter Huss High School. So now let's turn our attention to the Career Academy at York Chester Middle School. And Dr. Amy Holbrook, the principal at York Chester, is with us. And Dr. Holbrook, many of the same questions for you. How would you describe your choice and magnet program in 100 words or less?
Well, thank you for the opportunity, Todd. I really appreciate it. York Chester is an innovative design career academy. Well, we're an all-inclusive school that encourages students to take advantage of all opportunities. We have strong academics through project and game-based instruction. And our classes support the digital design and gaming art design pathways at Hunter Huss. These classes are multimedia gaming design, animation, robotics. We have hands-on experiences on how to design video games. We create digital art. We create things with 3D printers. And we also have web design. So we're also the only school in the state that offers a global art exchange. So with that, we get to have, we get to share artwork with other countries, students of the same age, and then we receive artwork with other countries. The kids get to view the artwork, critique it. Sometimes it's the physical artwork, and other times it's digital. With this pandemic, we've had to switch to a digital format. There has been a little delay, but the students get to actually have some dialogue with those students who created that artwork, and that's definitely something that's unique with York Chester. So our kids get to know different cultures, backgrounds of students of their same age that live across the world from them. but we also have a lot of wraparound services and our caring staff. And so that we create an environment for our students that is supportive and helps them be able to expand and reach whatever goals that they have coming up.
You've mentioned a couple of the classes, the pathways, the courses mm-hmm. that students take. If you had to identify one or two of those programs that are really engaging and the students really, really love, what program gains the most interest?
I would definitely say the multimedia gaming design. And then within our robotics, we're partnered up with Project Lead the Way. So it's more than just robotics. They do all types of team building activities and really hands-on activities. So anytime you can have middle school students do hands-on activities, they're going to be all about that.
Okay. Three words that best describe your program.
I would say inclusive, innovative, and design. So at York Chester, we are a small school. We have a number, our usual ratio is 1 to 20, so one teacher to 20 students, and that's very unique for us. Different than what Southwest does, everybody has an opportunity to participate in our Career Academy approach. And so the game-based instruction and project-based instruction is woven throughout all the classes. And so that way, I would say the innovative design and then being inclusive for all types of students and experiences.
And I think it's important to note that there are different programs at York Chester and different programs at Southwest, but regardless of where a student may be, that student going on to Hunter Huss will have the opportunity to engage in that program.
Yes.
Okay. Let's turn our attention to Hunter Huss High School, the home of the Career Academy for, of course, high school students. And with us is Dr. Brian Denton, the principal. And let's begin. Let's hear from you 100 words or less, Dr. Denton. How would you describe the choice program, the academy at Hunter Huss?
Certainly. It's hard to get it in under 100 words, but I'll do my best. One of the things that I'm happy to say about our program is we provide exposure to 14 of the 16 career clusters that are identified in North Carolina, which is just about all you can offer. And what we do with those is provide immersive, hands-on, and real-world experiences to our students that really do help prepare them for careers in the future. And we also try to infuse all of our academic offerings with career connections and real world relevance.
And I also think it's important to note, you mentioned 14 career pathways, cluster areas. The state has 16, but for two of those, they do not have the curriculum.
Correct.
So you really have all that the state offers at Hunter Huss.
Correct.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about some of the courses or pathways, the classes that students take in the Career Academy at Hunter Huss.
Certainly. Within those 14 pathways or 14 clusters are a number of pathways. Those include health science, foods and nutrition, fire safety, which we have the only fire academy in Gaston County Schools and one of the few in the state, emergency management technician, EMT classes, public safety, general technology, as well as the more specific game art design, Adobe digital design and Adobe digital animation, general business education courses, accounting, Python programming, and early childhood education.
And with the information you just shared, you can see how the courses that are offered at the middle school level are connected to the courses that are offered at the high school level.
Absolutely. It's been a great connection as that got underway, in fact, that our teachers and the teachers at Southwest and York Chester were able to collaborate on how to integrate that between the two programs.
If you had to select three words that best describe the Career Academy at Hunter Huss, what would those three words be?
Well, I've used one of them already, which is hands-on. I think at Hunter Huss, when you learn about becoming a fireman, or firefighter, you do not just hear about it. You actually put on the equipment. We have an entire room set up with fire hydrants, all the uniform equipment, If you're learning how to break into a door to get to rescue someone from a fire, we have a setup where they can do that. It's the true experience. The same goes with health science. Rather than just learning how you take blood pressure and vitals, you actually do it. In our foods classes, you don't just learn about food and the recipes. You prepare the dish and serve it. So it's really hands-on. Another word I would use is unique. And I've alluded to that a little bit. We have the most career clusters offered and some that are programs that almost no other schools have, fire being a perfect example of that. We just this year started offering the Python programming, which is new in the curriculum for CTE programs. And we were happy to have that and expanding our game art design. We were one of the first schools to have that. So a lot of unique opportunities to explore careers far beyond what many people think of when they think of what used to be known as vocational education. And then the third word I would use is accomplished. I'm very happy to always tell everyone that last school year, our students earned over 2,900 career certifications and credentials based on their coursework. And that was the second highest number in the entire state of North Carolina. We also have students who go to competitions related to their careers or participate in career technical student organizations. And our students come back with awards, gold medals at the Family and Consumer Leaders of America conference. We have a statewide officer for Skills USA, which is related to the EMT public safety pathway. So our students are achieving. And I think with those credentials come the true career advancement, as we have students who have moved on, have graduated now from the Career Academy directly into careers as firefighters, as CNAs, or enrolled in nursing school programs, who have gone straight into the industry with our foods program, where they are working in restaurants and learning to continue their culinary education. So those are my three words.
If there's one thing that you want parents and students and the community to know about the Career Academy, what is it?
I definitely want people to know, beyond those accolades, that we are not just a program for students who plan to go straight to the workforce. We continue to offer the full comprehensive high school program, including advanced placement and college level courses for our students. And many of our highest academically achieving students are participating in our Career Academy programs. And we also have, beyond our traditional CTE, career technical education programs, have other career avenues students can explore, such as a wonderful Army ROTC program and a teacher cadet program for people who are interested in going into education as a career. Hunter Huss has over 60 years of outstanding success and accomplishment, and we want everybody to know that about our school.
Well, thank you all for sharing about the Career Academy program. We are going to shift our attention now to the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy. And for this academy, middle school certainly is a time of exploration and discovery for students. And the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy gives them an opportunity to learn about exciting career possibilities in the areas of industry, computer science, and engineering. Now more than ever, industries need highly skilled employees who have knowledge and training in technology and engineering, and they are looking to our high school graduates as the next generation of tech-savvy professionals who can meet the demand. The Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy in Bessemer City is focused on preparing students for promising careers in engineering, technology, and industry-based professions such as masonry, carpentry, advanced manufacturing, and others. So we begin our presentations about the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy with the program at Bessemer City Middle School. And with us is the principal, Dr. Jessica Mellon. And Dr. Mellon, thank you for being with us. And take 100 words to describe the program at Bessemer City Middle School.
Thank you, Todd. So as you've already shared, we have the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy at Bessemer City Middle School, and we have two major areas of focus, which are computer sciences, which helps students to learn how to program and code computers to get them to do what we want them to do, And then we also have the Industrial Engineering Academy that focuses on the use of that technology along with the human capital and other resources to solve problems in the real world and in industry. Really, our goal is to expose students to the basic concepts surrounding these two areas so that they can build a good foundation so that they do a deeper exploration as they move on up into high school. So we know that the sooner students find what they're really interested in and start to focus on that, the more successful they're going to be, not only in middle school, but in high school and beyond. So we appreciate that we can serve that role for students, and we work really hard with our high school to make sure we support them as they move on up beyond middle school.
What are some of the classes or courses that the students are involved in that the students seem to really enjoy?
Well, we have a number that students love. We have the Project Lead the Way curriculum, which is really recognized nationally as being kind of the top of the career and technical education. So we those are probably our deepest and richest courses that students really enjoy, one of which is design and modeling. And that's where they really start to get the foundations of the engineering process and thinking like an engineer. And it is a program that puts their hands on whatever it is they're studying. At the very end, they have a culminating project where they actually have to design a toy that is adapted for someone with cerebral palsy. So it really takes them from the beginning of a problem to tracing it all the way to actually creating whatever it is that they're designing. We also have automation and robotics, which uses the VEX robotics platform. Students learn how to program traffic lights and robotic arms and other automated machinery that would be used in industry. And we're also really excited this year. One of our favorites has been the introduction to construction. And that's really to help support and start getting those foundational concepts for students who want to move into that masonry and carpentry program up into the high school. We weren't sure how that was going to look with COVID, but when you go in that shop, every child has their own little workbench and they are learning how to use hammers and screwdrivers. And they actually, as a class, got to decide what they wanted to build as their project. And they chose coin hole boards. So everybody, they worked on that and learned so much about measurement, how to use various tools, jointure, all that stuff. And then they got to take their little coin hole boards home with them and challenge their parents to a little competition. So it was really awesome. But I think construction has been one of the favorites that we've added this year. And we look forward to that continuing to grow over the next few years.
I think as you talk, it comes to mind, you are building a foundation. You're establishing that foundation. And it is really great to hear that. So what are three words that you would use to describe the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy at Bessemer City Middle School?
That's so easy. It would be, we choose success. That is our school motto. We say it, we start our day with it every day. And it's kind of, I think it's important for middle schoolers to understand that right now they're going to be faced with tons of choices, not only personally, but academically. It's a time of great change, but we want them to understand how impactful those small choices are, that they lead to student success. Whether they're deciding how the code to put into a computer, that's going to impact the outcome, but also the choices they make in terms of whether to participate in the academy and be a part of that program can have a huge impact on their success. So our motto is we choose success. So those are our three words we would choose.
And let's think about what is the most important thing that you want students and parents and the community to know about your choice program?
Well, I think you've already hit on it, and that is that we're laying the groundwork. We're putting in place that foundation. We don't expect the work that students do here to end when they leave. We expect them to continue on and explore in those areas of interest. We want them to also explore their career interests. When students leave us, they have a career plan in hand to help them in high school and beyond. So we want to set them up for success. We are playing a very important role in helping get them started on the right track to career and college goals.
And when your eighth graders become ninth graders, we want them to go right into the Industrial and Engineering Academy at Bessemer City High School. And Dr. Sheila Wyant is with us. And Dr. Wyant, at the high school level, let's talk about your program. And how would you describe the Technology and Industrial Engineering Academy at Bessemer City High School?
Thank you, Todd. The technology component at the high school is our advanced manufacturing courses. We offer advanced manufacturing 1 and 2, and they focus on the innovation that's occurring in manufacturing today in plants all across the United States. The industrial aspect includes our masonry and carpentry classes. And engineering is just that. We use the nationally recognized program Project Lead the Way, and we use their courses. They include Introduction to Engineering, Principles of Engineering, Civil Engineering. We even have advanced placement courses that students can take in the engineering pathway. And we're very excited to partner with Bessemer City Middle. In fact, we share a career development coordinator, and she works here and there with the teachers to make sure that what they're doing in the middle school is prepping them for what we're doing here. So it's the perfect marriage, if you will, between the two schools.
It is good to point out the connections that you have at the middle school level that extend to the high school level, really in your program, but also in the Career Academy, that you have those connections. And those are very important for students to have and for parents to see. So with the program at Bessemer City High School, what really makes it stand out?
That we have experts in the field teaching the classes. Our engineering classes are taught by an NC State graduate engineer. She actually was an engineer in the real world, so to speak, before coming into teaching. Our advanced manufacturing teacher, he worked 30 years in manufacturing. So he knows when he's teaching it, he knows what he's talking about. And our masonry teacher is a brick mason. He actually was a brick mason and still works on the side doing work as a mason. So he actually knows what he's doing. I think that's what sets us apart. Our teachers just didn't go to school and learn it out of a book. They've actually worked in the career field in which they are now teaching.
And I think that's an excellent example of making those connections, where teachers who have been in the field are helping students make those connections. Thank you for pointing that out. So if you had to choose 3 words to describe your program, what would the 3 words be?
I've got to ask for forgiveness to use 4. Building excellence in everything. Because our goal here is to build on what we already have. We have a rich tradition at Bessemer City High School, and we want to build on that. And we use that word, of course, because we are the Technology Industrial Engineering Academy. Because in engineering, you're building. In masonry and carpentry, you're building. Advanced manufacturing, you're building things in a manufacturing world. So that's why we chose that, building excellence in everything. And that includes the fact that we have more to offer than just those. We offer nursing. We offer food nutrition. We offer business classes. So we offer a comprehensive CTE program as well. And, of course, that includes many, many other courses that students can take. So they can get their pathway in our academy, but they can also get a second pathway in an additional CTE program while they're here.
And if you had to point out the most important thing that you want parents and students and the community to know about your program, what would that be?
That we are a comprehensive high school, but we're a small high school. 600 students generally is how many we house in this building. And we're able to build strong relationships with students and their families and make connections with them that last sometimes beyond high school. Students come back to us and they come back to visit. They come back and support our school. So I think that relationship piece is huge here in our small town and our small community. And I don't want people to forget that, because sometimes bigger is not always better. Small can be a great thing.
Thank you for sharing that information, and to all of our principals with us today. We certainly appreciate your presentations. And after you hear about these great programs, you are really impressed to find out what is going on in our schools related to the school choice options at Southwest, York Chester, Hunter Huss, and at Bessemer City Middle School and Bessemer City High School. So we've heard the great information about these specific programs. I do want to give Ms. McLean and Ms. Serbeck an opportunity to share some general highlights about the school choice process.
Thank you, Mr. Hagans. Just a few things that I would emphasize to families as they are making decisions about their choice program. Applications are online. We would ask that you would visit our school choice website, where you will find a link to actually fill out or complete your application, but they are online. Secondly, I would say, as a reminder, to submit your application by Sunday, February the 28th. Again, Sunday, February 28th is the date that all applications must be submitted by. In terms of our lottery is virtual this year. You do not have to be present to attend, but that will take place on Thursday, April the 1st. Finally, I would say you will receive an email notification once the selections are made, so you don't have to contact anyone. It will come to you automatically, letting you know whether or not you received your choice seat. So those are a few reminders that I would give to parents.
Okay, thank you for that information. Now we would like to give our participants an opportunity to submit general questions about school choice using the Q&A feature that is available through this webinar. At the bottom of your screen, you should see the Q&A icon, which allows you to submit a question. We do ask you to keep your questions general, since we have a number of people participating in the webinar. If you have a specific question that's related to your child or your family, we will have someone contact you offline to discuss your specific question. We certainly do not want to share personal information here in the webinar. And if someone asks a question that we cannot answer right now, we will get your contact information and we will get an answer to you. So let's see what questions we have in the Q&A feature. And I will ask Ms. McLean and Ms. Serbeck's help, as well as our principal's help, if there's a specific question about a program to help answer the questions as I try to facilitate our Q&A time. One of the questions that we have received, Ms. Serbeck, you may be able to answer this one. If someone needs help with the online application, I would assume that person contacts your office.
That's correct, Todd. Thank you. You can contact my office. We're also located at One Learning Place. Due to the pandemic, we're not allowing a lot of people in the building, but we're doing that as safely as we can and would love to help. I would also, Mr. Higgins, like to add that please apply for as many programs as your child may be interested in. Sometimes people think they can only apply for one academy, and that is not correct. So feel free to apply for as many. I'm happy to give anyone my information to contact me for any help you may need.
Thank you for that. Our next question, Ms. McLean, relates to transportation and school buses and whether bus transportation is provided. Will you share some insight on that?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Transportation is provided to our magnet programs, and these are schools where all of the students come into the program from across the district. However, with our academy programs, they are parents provide transportation. So yes, parents would need to provide transportation to any of the programs outside of our magnet school programs.
And so in the case of the Career Academy programs and the technology and engineering programs at Bessemer City, the family would be responsible providing that transportation if they live outside of the school attendance area.
That is correct. They will provide transportation.
Okay. I know that some of our programs allow students, we have a few programs that do allow students to enter. When you enter a school choice program, that usually takes place at the kindergarten, sixth grade, and ninth grade levels. However, we do have some programs that allow a student to enter at another grade level. One of the questions that we have, if a child enters a program, say, for example, as a 10th grader, a high school program, the question is, would that child be behind in what he or she needs to do in that program?
And I will answer that. And no, this will give the students still an opportunity to take all of the courses that they need to, in a sense, catch up with the other students in the program. However, it's only up to the first semester, start of the first semester, that students could enter the program. If it's beyond that, then it does put them far behind and does not give them ample time to stay on track with their regular graduation courses. and then still meet the requirements for their choice program. So again, at the start of the 10th grade year, if there are seats available.
Okay. We have a question about the demographics related to the faculty and staff at York Chester and at Southwest. And I know, Dr. Holbrook, you mentioned earlier in your presentation about being inclusive as a word that best describes your program. Will you talk just briefly about the demographics at York Chester?
Well, actually, I have them here. We have 42% are African-American, 25% is Hispanic. Our Caucasian group is 24%, and then 7% is multi-race. So of our students at York Chester.
Okay, and Ms. Hester, if you would like to share some information about demographics related to your school.
Absolutely, Todd. Southwest is one of the most diverse schools in the district. Our demographics are 35% Caucasian, 33% African-American, 29% Hispanic, and the remainder is multiracial. And I will also add that Southwest has the largest geographic area that we have within our district lines for middle schools. So with about 865 students, we are the largest middle school.
Okay. We have a question about the requirements to be approved to get into the York Chester program. Dr. Holbrook, would you like to talk a little bit about those requirements?
Well, really, we're open. If you want to be honest, the requirements, as would be on the frequently asked questions, just make sure that they have a C or above average. But as a sixth grader coming in, if you choose York Chester, you're going to be able to be accepted. We do have spots available for seventh and eighth graders, and just meeting those transfer requirements are what's necessary.
And Ms. McLean or Ms. Serbeck, is there anything that you would like to add related to the requirements?
Yes, Todd, I can answer that. So you do have to meet transfer conditions, and let me explain what that means. That means your child must be in good standing in three areas, and that is your attendance, your grades, and no behavior. So when you apply for your child, if you're unsure about that, we check that and then we respond to you with the meeting of those requirements for these two programs. They are open to rising sixth graders and rising ninth graders. We're at this time not opening that up to upper grades.
And so I think that if you do have specific questions about those requirements, of course, go to the website that has the frequently asked questions there, and also feel free to contact the school, because someone there at the school will be able to walk you through that process of getting into that program. Okay, now the next question we have is talking about the number of spots available at Hunter Huss High School. So Dr. Denton, will you talk a little bit about the availability at Hunter Huss at the ninth grade level?
Yes, sir. We currently are allocated 60 seats for students outside of our attendance zone to be in our academy. Students who are already in our attendance zone can be involved in the Career Academy without limit. And we're fortunate with the number of programs we have to have lots of spots in all those different clusters for students to sign up for specific pathways.
Thank you for that information. Our next question relates to these programs and virtual learning. Of course, we have lived in a virtual learning environment for the past 10 to 11 months. And all of us on our webinar here, we would love to say that the effects of the virus will be over with by next school year. That would be wonderful. I think maybe Ms. McLean, that our advice to parents would be to plan as if next year would be a regular school year. And then it's hard for us to predict the future, but the virtual learning aspect, if that needs to be put into place because of where we're at with the pandemic, certainly, you know, that's something we will have to look at. But I think the advice would be for parents and students to just plan ahead as if we were having a regular school year.
And I would agree with you, Todd, in saying that. The other thing that I would say, we want parents to realize it's important that students are attending their choice program. If they're selected to hold a seat at one of the programs, that they are attending the program in person. And for instance, Mr. Denton talked about the opportunities that his students have with hands-on learning opportunities. And if they are not able to participate face-to-face by being in attendance at their program, they miss out on so many important aspects of that that program. So again, students selected for a choice seat will need to attend their program in person next school year.
Thank you for that information. And we have about 4 minutes left for our webinar. So I do want to address a couple more questions that are available. The information about the demographics, I know we shared the demographics for the students. Ms. Hester and Dr. Holbrook, do you have demographic information available for your faculty and staff?
Mr. Higgins, we believe strongly that our staff should reflect the demographics of our students. And at Southwest, we have done a good job trying to meet that challenge. We can't say that we're 100% 33 this or 28% this, but that is definitely a consideration in our hiring. We also hire visiting international faculty members. We feel like they bring a real experiential opportunity for students to enhance cultural aspects. So that is something that is important, and we recognize helps build those relationships with our students and our families.
And I would just speak on the same thing as Ms. Hester did. We definitely at York Chester look at our staff as one, it's a caring staff. And, you know, caring staff, we put your kids' needs first. And we do try to, we have an inclusive staff, but we also have a feeling that we need to represent the same population that we teach. And so with that being said, I don't have the exact numbers, and I was actually trying to count up our people here while we were discussing that, because I did miss that question. But to be honest with you, the first thing that you need to know is that all of our staff members are here for your students, and we want to make sure that your child gets the best education possible and that they focus on pride and excellence. And that's really what we're committed to, York Chester, in every facet of the words pride and excellence.
Let's try to look at one more question. It is related to if a student is in a middle school program. Let's say, for instance, you're in the middle school program at Southwest. Do you automatically get to go to the program, the Career Academy at Hunter Huss?
Well, Mr. Hay, I'm not sure if Dr. Denton would like to address that. The children that are in, that reside in the Southwest feeder attend one of two high schools, and that would be Hunter Huss or Forest View High School. If they are in the Hunter Huss district, they do not have to apply for the Career Academy at Hunter Huss. However, if they live in the Forest View district or any other district outside of the Hunter Huss district, they would need to apply through choice.
Yes, that is how we operate. As Ms. Hester just said, we certainly welcome all those applicants.
We have almost made it to 1 o'clock, the closing 4-hour webinar, and I appreciate the questions that have been submitted. And for those of you that maybe you've already thought of another question, or this afternoon you may think of another question, we do invite you to send us an email. The email address we'd like for you to use is schoolchoice@k12.nc.us, and we will be able to answer those questions for you. And if you have a question that is specific to a certain program or to your family or your child, we also ask you to use that email address, schoolchoice@gaston.k12.nc.us, to share your questions with us. In closing, we want to thank all of you for joining us for our school choice information session. This webinar coincides with this week being National School Choice Week. We realize that students and parents have options, and we sincerely appreciate you taking time to explore the many options and choices that we have available right here in Gaston County Schools. We certainly believe that choosing Gaston County Schools is the best choice because of the caring teachers, the effective academic programs, and the many outstanding resources that we have available for students. And we look forward to having your family as part of our 21 school choice programs in 2021. I would like to thank all of our presenters today for joining us and sharing information about their program. We invite you to go to the Gaston County Schools website and click on the school choice icon to learn more about school choice as well as our 21 programs. And we want to say once again, thank you so much for being with us here for our school choice information session, and we hope you have a great afternoon.